I can't promise you that.
He needs someone, Ada.
No, I didn't.
He's not going to make it by himself.
Look, you're just going to worry yourself sick trying to carry the world around, you know? Why don't you just wait for Vince to get in touch with you?
You're right.
Take the rest of the day off, okay? Get some rest.
I will take the rest of the day off. Thank you. I will go to the hospital, though.
Terrific.
If Reginald is sleeping, I'll rest there.
Sure you will.
I will. From.
I was wondering what happened to you. Am I wrong, or were you here before?
You're not wrong, Ada.
But you left.
I had something else to do.
Oh, did this something have anything to do with what's-his-face over here?
I was with Scott, yes.
And now you're back, and all's right with Mary's place. Okay?
Well, I have to go.
Back to the hospital?
My father needs me, Cheryl.
I know that, Scott. I know you love him. It's just I wish things were different.
So do I.
I guess I can't count on seeing you for a while. Unless I come down there.
I would like that a lot. I would also like it if you wouldn't go around playing detective on your own.
Look, I would do anything to help my pops, just like you would do for
your
father.
I know, I'm just worried you're going to get in trouble, that's all.
We were so close to proving that my father wasn't there that night, Scott. I can't believe all our efforts have come to a grinding halt.
But they have.
And now your father is saying that he saw my father out in the terrace, threatening.
Come on, Cheryl.
Your father is always accusing my pops of everything, and it's all lies, saying that my pops threw a knife like some clown in a circus. You take his word for it.
Cheryl, I want to find the truth as much as you do. Right now, I know about as much as you do.
Nothing.
That's right, nothing. The reality is my father was stabbed, and now he's had a heart attack. I have to deal with that right now. He needs me. Everything else is secondary right now.
The staff order to stop knocking me out every 4 hours or so with those drugs. Why can't they just leave me be?
They want you to rest.
Well, it's driving me insane.
Reginald, this is a hospital. These people are trying to take care of you.
I can take care of myself.
Obviously.
I can't work with all these sedatives in me.
Your only job right now is to get well.
Yes, I suppose you're right. I thought I was a man of steel, you see. Ice water in my veins. Inhuman.
No such luck.
I'll bet you thought that, too.
At times.
What about right now?
Right now, I see the man behind the face. The man who is loving and gentle and vulnerable.
I've let you down so badly, Mary.
You've been a victim in all this, too. I can see that now. It hasn't been easy on you. I think I understand why you hold on so tightly to this facade you present to the world. You feel you have to seem all powerful, because if you don't, you're just going to be open to all kinds of attacks.
Then you do understand.
No, you've been under a lot of stress.
It never ends, Mary.
I have to ask you something.
Go on.
But I need a really honest answer.
That's all you'll ever get from now on, Mary, I swear.
What did you see on the terrace just before you collapsed?
Oh, that's not important now.
It is. Why did you pull the gun out?
I'm not sure.
You said you'd tell the truth.
That is the truth.
All right. What did you think you saw?
Prince McKinnon.
Why can't you be sure?
Because I didn't really see his face.
Well, then how can you know that it was him?
I said I wasn't sure. I'm not sure of anything, don't you see? All these attacks from all, every side, it's just like my mind in a whirl. Michael Hudson in this photograph. Can you imagine that? Thinking I deliberately hurt Donna. It's only a photo of the twins. Why would I try to hurt my own daughter? Michael Hudson just won't give up.
Business and everything.
He can't have. His body has to rest. He can't think about anything but relaxing.
Right. I got these papers that he had asked me to get from...
Put them away. Hide them.
Okay.
We are going to see to it that he has nothing to worry about.
You remember in Paraguay when I got bitten by that spider?
Yeah. Remember how frightened we were?
Yeah. Just by my bedside for days.
Yes, he was. Around the clock. He slept in the chair next to your bed.
And every time I woke up, I remember I saw his face.
I remember one day when you were burning up with fever.
Yeah.
He bathed you. So gentle.
Yeah.
loves you so much.
Yeah, and people, like these people in Bay City, they've never seen that side of him. I mean, they think he's a liar. They think he's always out to get somebody.
He has lied. Wish I knew why.
No. No, I...
Donna, he's always worried about her.
Well, sure, it's because they've accused him of hurting her, and he swears he didn't.
Well, Gomez has already confessed to drug...
No, no, it's not that. Something to do with a photograph of the twins that he evidently or supposedly showed her and it drove her over the edge.
You think that's true?
Mary's place.
I'd know that voice anywhere.
I'm busy, Chad.
MJ.
I can't talk.
Okay, I won't keep you, but I just want to tell you I got big plans for us tonight.
Forget it.
You're going to love it.
I'm hanging up now, Chad.
Okay. But I'll see you later, okay?
No, you won't.
Chill out, baby. Come on. You're going to have a ball tonight.
You look pretty.
No, I don't. I'm still wearing my pink whistle outfit. I've got all the makeup.
Why? My parents are going to love it.
Your parents are never going to see it.
Yeah, it's a good thing, too. Listen, I'm all ready to go. You're not going to hold me up, are you?
No, I just have to go home and change. I got my clothes all picked out.
No, good, because, you know, this party's in your honor, and the honoree can't keep the guests waiting.
We've got plenty of time, okay? Would you just relax?
Oh, you're back, honey. I'm taking the rest of the day off.
I was, but Reginald fell asleep again. Has there been any sign of him?
Nope, not when I'm here.
He's never going to see that ad.
Home from Paraguay. Your wife needs to meet with you. You know where. Immediately. My wife. My wife.